Prophetess Cebile, 7750 Media. We're still on insights of the 28th of Av, 5784. Same, the 1st of September, 2024. I saw the car number plated MD65DP, meaning that there is a head or king of industry who is deep in pandemonium of paradise lost. I don't know who the Lord is referring to, but perhaps that's not for me to worry about. I just wish God would stop using me as the Bathsheba that sleeps in the beds of men of power. In the kingdom of Eswatini, most of the government offices are on Mhlambanyatsi Road. I don't know what the name means, but I know the message the Lord has conveyed to me from it. It begins with King David strutting on the roof of his palace and seeing Bathsheba, the wife of Uriah the Hittite, bathing. 2 Samuel 11:2 says in the voice, early one evening, David rose from his bed and was strolling on the palace roof when he saw a woman bathing on a roof below his. She was very beautiful. The Siswati and Zulu Bible use the word gugeza for bathing. The Xhosa Bible uses the word hlamba, so that works perfectly for me. We all know what happened thereafter. King David had an adulterous illicit affair with Bathsheba, the wife of one of his mighty men, and he in effect made her his mistress. The Sesotho word for a mistress is inyati. The same word is used for a buffalo in Siswati. And do not forget the context. Do not forget that Cleopatra became the mistress and concubine of two of Rome's most powerful men, that being Julius Caesar and Mark Antony. And she, in fact, had children with them. So now let's go back to the government offices on Mhlambanyatsi Road in Mbabane, Kingdom of Eswatini. Let's translate the word Mhlambanyatsi as the bathing mistress, that being Bathsheba. When you are bathing, you are also ritually cleansing yourself of dirt or defilement of some kind. So Mhlambanyatsi could also mean that a ritual cleansing or purification from something. And in this case, from the mistress called Inyatsi in Sesotho. Let's continue the story of King David and Bathsheba. In 2 Samuel 11, verses 3 to 4, it says that David sent and inquired about the woman. One said, Is it not Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliam, and the wife of Uriah the Hittite? And David sent messages and took her. Pardon me, he sent messengers and took her. And she came to him, and he lay with her, for she was purified from her uncleanness. Then she returned to her house. So there we go. The voice refers to it as a purifying bath. The GNT refers to it as her monthly ritual purification. I don't know what happens at the government office buildings at Mhlambanyatsi Road, but perhaps too many heads of entities are committing King David type adulteries with their own Bathshebas. We are still in the month of Av, the month of the patriarchs and fathers. So I suppose perhaps too many fathers and patriarchs are committing adultery. Bathsheba can also be rendered as bath and look with your eyes from the Sotho word, which is sheba. In which case, the Lord may be saying that the government officers need to look at being ritually purified or cleansed because of some illicit affairs and deal making. God sees everything, even though some think that they are doing things in secret. It is worrying that the Lord points this out after I have been watching this docuseries on Queen Cleopatra, who came from a dynasty with both Greek and Egyptian practices of brother loving or sibling loving incestuous marriages. And with Cleopatra in particular, her sexual affairs produced illegitimate children with Julius Caesar and Mark Antony. I hear Ave Maria again. So I guess there are too many presidential sex models and kittens parading themselves in front of men of power and influence in order to gain favors, positions, deals, and the like. As I said, I have no clue where and how this is going on, but God does. And the good thing is I just speak what I hear. And if he wants to expose, he will do so, as he has in fact been doing. So I will leave my story here with Mistress Bathsheba for now. Thanks for listening. Mm-hmm.